tracking you, Mandalorian. I'm here for the armor.
If you want my armor, you'll have to peel it off my dead body.
I don't want your armor. I want my armor.
Oh, that's amazing.
Excited to share with you that John and Dave are concurrently developing two new spin-off series exclusively for Disney Plus. One, The Rangers of the New Republic, and the other featuring fan favorite Ahsoka Tano.
No way! Hell yeah.
The timeline of The Mandalorian. These interconnected shows, along with future stories, will excite new audiences, embrace our most passionate fans, and will culminate in a climactic story event.
Nice.
The next chapter, with each era being a rich resource for storytelling. Now with Disney Plus,
yes,
we can explore limitless story possibilities like never before.
I am so ready.
And fulfill the promise that there is truly a Star Wars story for everyone. One of the most exciting and ambitious new series we have coming to Disney for 2022 is Andor, a tense thriller in the Star Wars universe.
Cool.
Created by Tony Gilroy.
Cassian Andor, they finally gave it a title.
Tony's incredible success. Diego Luna will be back in the role of rebel spy Cassian Andor from Rogue One, and he will be joined by a fantastic new cast that includes Stellan Skarsgård, Arjona, Fiona Shaw, Denise Goff, Kyle Soller, and Genevieve O'Reilly as Mon Mothma.
Oh, nice.
We just began production in London 2 weeks ago.
There's tons of possibilities to explore. It is the building of a revolution.
Okay, so we're not seeing any actual footage. Still, I've been excited for that for a while. I feel like it's been like 3+ years that we've been waiting for something on that.
Oh. We announced the return of Ewan McGregor in the iconic role of Jedi Master Obi-Wan Kenobi for a special event series on Disney Plus. Obi-Wan Kenobi begins 10 years after the dramatic events of the downfall and corruption of his best friend and Jedi apprentice, Anakin Skywalker.
Oh, okay, so like halfway between episodes 3 and 4.
Darth Vader. Our fans will be thrilled that Hayden Christensen will be returning in the role of Darth Vader.
Yes, dude! Oh my goodness, I can't believe they just dropped that.
The series is directed by Deborah Chow, as a director on season 1 of The Mandalorian.
Yeah, chapter 3.
Production will begin in March of next year. Here's an early look at Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Oh, I wish they would have saved the Anakin, the Hayden Christensen reveal for the actual show. That will be, I mean, I kind of expected him anyway, but it would have been really nice to have that be a surprise. But nonetheless, that's awesome. Oh, I'm so excited for Hayden, man. He really deserves the opportunity to put a fresh spin on that performance.
Star Wars The Clone Wars saw tremendous success with its epic 7th and final season. On the legacy of The Clone Wars, our new animated series, The Bad Batch, follows the special...
Okay, we knew this was coming.
...work on new missions in a rapidly changing galaxy. This is The Bad Batch.
Oh, we're gonna see some footage from this?
They call themselves The Bad Batch.
Or is this just from season 7? Nice. It's in the exact same animation style. Sweet. Oh, that was Fennec Shand. That's supposed to be Fennec Shand, right? A very young Fennec Shand.
quite an impressive display.
Tarkin's back. Cool, man. It's kind of a way of, like, getting Clone Wars, new Clone Wars, but focused on the Bad Batch. I'm there. I'm ready to watch it.
Star Wars Visions will be a series of animated short films celebrating the Star Wars galaxy through the lens of the world's best anime creators.
Anime short films?
10 fantastic visions from several of the leading Japanese anime studios.
What?
Diverse cultural perspective to Star Wars. Lando Calrissian is the galaxy's smoothest, most notorious scoundrel. And he'll return in a brand new event series for Disney Plus.
An event series.
Justin Simien, creator of the critically acclaimed and hugely popular Dear White People, is developing the story with us now. Massive Star Wars fan himself, Justin has put together a reel to give you a sense of the style, tone, and irresistible swagger of our upcoming series, Lando.
Oh, nice.
Leslie Headland, Emmy-nominated mind-bending series Russian Doll, is a boldly innovative filmmaker bringing her new Star Wars series to Disney+. The Acolyte is a mystery thriller that will take you to a galaxy of shadowy secrets and emerging dark side powers in the final days of the High Republic era.
Oh, cool.
Lucasfilm Animation will be teaming up with our unparalleled visual effects team, ILM, to develop a special Star Wars adventure for Disney+. Epic Journey will introduce us to a new hero guided by our most iconic duo, R2-D2 and C-3PO, on a special mission known only to them. What could possibly go wrong?
Okay, so I had to come back and record this a little bit later, but it looks like, in addition to The Mandalorian, they also announced Rangers of the New Republic. I don't know the specifics of that. I want to hear more about that. I don't know if that's going to include maybe Bo-Katan and Cara Dune or something similar, but that sounds interesting. And that's a spinoff along with Ahsoka, which we knew was coming with Rosario Dawson. So I'm assuming the Ahsoka show is going to be the Rebels sequel that we've been waiting for. Andor is the title they gave to Cassian. That's been a few years coming. The Obi-Wan Kenobi series, I had a feeling Hayden Christensen was going to be coming back, but here they just announced it instead of dropping it during the show, which I think would have probably been better, but this is still exciting to hear. So I was stoked to hear that, and I'm glad that they announced that. Bad Batch, we knew was coming, and it looked like it had Fennec Shand in it. Bad Batch, I'm assuming, is supposed to be like 25 years prior to The Mandalorian, so that would be a very young Fennec Shand, but that was definitely her. Star Wars Visions, that I'm excited for. Anime shorts, like Japanese anime short animated films, I'm excited for that. Lando, I'm assuming that's going to be Donald Glover. The Acolyte will be High Republic Dark Side stuff. I want to hear more about that. And then a droid story. Unfortunately, we didn't really get any trailers other than the Bad Batch. I'm particularly looking forward to when they drop the Obi-Wan Kenobi trailer officially. If anything, just to see Hayden Christensen get to reprise his role. Although this time he's going to be presumably in a Darth Vader costume, so we may not even see his face. But it doesn't matter. I'm just super pumped that we learned that today. I'm obviously looking forward to seeing everything that they just dropped. But definitely Obi-Wan Kenobi in particular. I'm obviously excited for Ahsoka and Rangers of the New Republic. I want to hear more about that because that could be anything if it's a spinoff of The Mandalorian. So lots of new good Star Wars content coming out. And I'm going to have plenty to react to. So I'm excited for that. And I'm looking forward to seeing you guys then. Bye.